I'll be explaining how to use your iPhone or iPad to capture a 3D model with Matterport. So here's the list of things that you're going to need to capture a 3D model with your iPhone. First thing is either an iPhone or iPad. If you're using the iPhone, it's going to be the 6S or newer. If you're on the iPad, it can be the Air 2 or newer. But if you're using either an iPhone or iPad with the extra wide angle lens, which is going to be the iPhone 11 or newer or the new iPad Pro, there is a little bit of a benefit to that, and I'll get to that later. You're also going to need a Matterport account. So if you don't already have one, it's really easy. Just go to buy.matterport.com. It's free. You can sign up with only your name and email address. And lastly, of course, you're going to need the Matterport Capture app. So go to the App Store and search for Matterport. You'll find Matterport Capture. Just download and install that. Once you've got all that, just go ahead and launch the Capture app. At this point, you can sign into your account. You can either do that now, or you can do that prior to uploading your model. Either way, before you upload the model, you'll have to sign into your account via the app. Once you're past the sign-in process, the application is going to download Cortex. Now, this is the engine that automatically converts your 2D panoramas captured with your phone into a 3D model. So this is very important. It might take a little bit of time. It totally depends on your internet connection, but it is worth it. And once Cortex is installed, you are ready to go. So at this point, I'm just going to go ahead and hit the plus button in the bottom right corner to create a new model. The address automatically comes up, and I can choose to either edit that address if it's not exactly correct, or I can scroll down and just enter the name of the model that I'd like to have. Hit save, and our model is created, and I'm ready to do my first scan. Before we actually get to capturing the model, which I'll show you in the next video, I just want to point out a couple buttons around the capture button itself. You'll notice just above the capture button is a button that currently says iPhone, and that's because I don't have any other camera connected, so this becomes my default capture device. So if I tap iPhone just above the capture button, you'll notice that appears a small menu that allows me to choose between the iPhone being my capture device or a different camera. The other thing I wanted to bring to your attention is the options button. If I tap that, up comes a small menu. It allows me to choose between 3D scans and 360 capture. There's a lot of information at support.matterport.com that covers the differences between those two, so I won't get into that here. But I just wanted to let you know, if you did need to change to a 360 capture, this is where it would be done. And the other thing, and this is really important, is whether you capture a simple scan or a complete scan. As you can see by these icons, the simple scan is just one ring around, and I'll have a little bit more on the top and bottom that's going to be blurred. But the complete scan completes more of the 360 sphere and allows me to see a lot more in the end. Because I'm capturing three 360 degree rings, it's going to be a little bit more time consuming, but the result will be a little bit more complete as well. In this case, I'm going to keep it on simple. Again, this is because I have the extra wide angle lens in my iPhone 11. So if you do have that, like I said before, it's going to be a little bit of an advantage for this reason. Because we're using Cortex to convert our 360 degree panoramas into a 3D model, outdoor photography is going to be a lot more tricky. So for this demonstration, we're only going to do indoors. I'm going to go ahead and scan my makeshift office over here just so I can have that very vivid and immersive memory of what this was like. All right, let's just go ahead and get started. So the first thing that you're going to want to do is keep your camera very, very steady against your body. So the way you do that is by keeping your elbows close to your body and holding the camera with two hands. This way, it's a strong kind of triangle or tripod, if you will, keeping the camera as steady as possible. Now, before I press the scan button, I just wanted to bring your attention to the fact that the camera itself is your pivot point. So what you don't want to do is what's probably most natural for all of us is to have our body be the pivot point and turning the camera around us like we do when capturing a landscape or panorama, something like that. What we do want to do is have the camera be the pivot point and we're actually turning around the camera. It definitely takes a little bit of getting used to, so I do recommend that you try a couple different techniques. I'll go over a few here today, and find out what works best for you. If you find a method that works better for you than what I've mentioned here, please let us know. So the first method is turning around your big toe. Place your foot on the ground and try and have the camera above your big toe, and then you can kind of pivot and turn around that. And the other method is just by practicing with a broomstick. I just happen to have one right here, and what I can do is set it down on the ground, and you can see how it clearly is a nice vertical pivot point. Just hold my phone up against it, and with everything straight up and down, I'll just go ahead and tap the scan button. You'll notice that I first see a little dot and a circle above it, and I want to line these up in order to capture my first scan. So what you don't want to do is push the entire stick forward in order to tilt the camera down. I want to keep the broomstick perfectly vertical and just tilt the camera by itself. Once the first picture has been captured, I can go either to the right or to the left. It doesn't really matter at this point. So again, keeping the stick as perfectly vertical as possible, I'm just going to turn the camera, aligning the circle and the dot. It's a little tricky because I have some furniture in the way, but we did all right. Now it's processing once that last picture has been captured, and it places that image in the mini map. Now all I need to do to finish off this small space is just one more scan about 4 to 5 feet away. I can go ahead and move in this direction, for example, press the scan button. Same thing again, align the circle and dot. All right, so now it's processing. Now with my second capture aligned, I can go ahead and put this away. And you can see based on the mini map that I do have a small area here overlapping between the first and second scan that it wasn't able to see. Hopefully the processing engine will fill that in, but I could add a third scan if I wanted to in order to fill that in. In this case, however, what I want to do is talk to you a little bit about markings. So because I don't want anything outside of the room to be included in the dollhouse, I'm going to go ahead and put in a trim marking. So to do that, you just press the markings button down here and now choose the scissors icon to draw a trim line. Just draw the trim line like that, and this will exclude everything on the remove side of the arrow. So the arrow is pointing towards this area here that I don't want to have included in the final model, and that's gonna get removed. I don't see that done here, but once everything is uploaded, you'll see that it'll come out really nice and clean. And like I said before, if you think that another scan position is necessary to more completely flesh out the space, that's totally up to you. You can scan as many positions as you'd like. I did also just want to bring your attention to the window and mirror marking buttons right over here. Use them accordingly when you come across a window or mirror in your space. But basically, that's really all there is to it. It's just a matter of moving yourself around the camera and not the camera around you, and moving about 4 to 5 feet to the next scan position in order to best align between the two positions. Once you're done, you just hit the upload button in the top right corner. It'll ask you if you want to do face blurring. And this is important if you do have any faces in pictures or people in the scene that you don't want their faces to be included in the final model. So if I do want that, this is the time to activate it, and then just press upload, and up it goes into your account. Once the model is done processing, you'll be emailed and you can go into your account and check it out. That's it. Have fun and get creative with it. Our model has been processed, and this model, because it's only two scan positions, really didn't take very long at all. First thing we want to do is just go ahead and hit the play button here to load the model. And once we're loaded, we can just have a quick look at it before we begin our edit. So this looks really good. I can move between the two different positions using either the keyboard or the mouse. Go into the padlock icon right up here to unlock the space, confirm, and then press the share arrow to get your share link. All I have to do at this point is press the copy button over here. I'll have copied the share link and I can share that on any social media that I want.